Hello and welcome to Design Inc. This is the sixth in a series of tutorials where we are setting up an interior design dashboard in Notion. If you've missed the first five tutorials, you should check those out so that you can build along with me. Once I finish building out the dashboard, I'll make the template available to you. So if you'd like one, sign up in the description. And if you don't want to miss a video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. In this tutorial, we are going to track our client inquiries. This pipeline will help us track the progress of our project. We'll also build out a client template, which we can use to capture those client inquiries and make sure that we don't miss a step. Here we are in our Notion database, and we're going to head into our contacts database that we have already created. And the first thing we're going to add is a client status. If we have a look at our whimsical dashboard, which we will see here, you can see that we've got our contact database. We're going to create our client, and the client has a status. So in the Notion database, you'll see we'll add a client status, and it's going to have a client. So we can call this an active client, a prospect, an opportunity, or a lead. And then we can also put in an extra one, which is past client. Now when we go in and we can actually say for these clients, we've got these two clients here. We don't have a name actually, so let's just call him Jones. And then we can say this is a new client. We could add in a few details later, but the most important thing is we know that this is an active client, and we know that John Paddington, for example, has moved from a lead to a prospect. And we'll go back when we look at our client portal, but essentially our client portal is going to track these statuses. We've got our three clients, and then we've got our client status. So the next thing we're going to do is to create a view of this client status. So we're going to create a page which is called the CRM pipeline. And the first thing that I wanted to do was add in some client documentation. Now this client documentation relates to the actual levels of our project. So remember, we've got our lead, our opportunity, prospect. So we can move this to active client or past client. Now, in order to create this, add a view of a contacts database, and I'm going to create a board, and I'm going to show the property of the contacts. And you can see here the filter, you've got the category of contact is client. So I've just chosen client from the dropdown, and that gives me this database. We can actually do this graphically by moving this client over to an active client, and we can just rearrange this and so on. So you can see here now we've got three active clients. We don't have anyone. Let's say we get a new lead. This is actually in the contacts database. So let's say we have someone called Harriet Miller. Then what we can do is we can fill out this thing. So we've got a client project. So if there's a page that we've already created, we can link it to that, but we can say the date created is today. We can add in an email address. So let's say it's harriet@miller.com.au. We can choose any other links that we have here. We can write a few notes. We can add in a phone number and so on. Now, we can also say we've got a website form. So we've got Harriet Miller down here as a lead, and we want to create a client template. So I've already created the template, but you can certainly copy it. I've placed this in a call-out block, and it's got our client names, our project address. We've also got our other contact details. So obviously, if they're not living in a living at their project, you might have a different address here. And I always like to embed a Google map, which makes life very easy, particularly if you're giving it to a staff member to head over to. You've got your home, your work, any entry instructions. So if there's security details or so on, you can enter this into here. Any children and may be appropriate, particularly if, for example, you're decorating children's rooms or building purpose-built rooms for other situations. I've added in a carer because some clients could have live-in care. Any pets that you might have, as well as emergency contacts, and then links. If they've just bought the place, they may have a link that's live that you can add into here. We can now head into creating a template for our project using this contacts database. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss a thing. I can't wait to get started. See you in the next video.